But to begin this hair tutorial, I'm going to show you how I achieve my gray hair color using my extensions from VP Fashion. I am using the white blonde extensions that come in a pale yellow color. I am wearing the 260 gram 22 inch set, and to be honest, the quality of these extensions have improved so much since the last time I got to try them. They feel thicker all the way down to the ends, so it's much easier now to blend with my thick hair. The packaging is much nicer than before as well. You'll get a case where you can safely store the extensions, you'll also get some extra clips, and you'll also receive a note with information with tips and advice on how you dye them and handle your extensions. So before I dye my extensions gray, I need to remove as much yellow as I can first, using silver shampoo. This is a very important step when dyeing your own hair gray as well. So when I dyed my hair gray, my hair wasn't the silvery white to begin with, so my hair ended shifting in a lot of blue and green, so this step is very important since all gray dye has blue pigments in them. After the shampooing is done, I move on to the dyeing process. I'm using Maria Nila's color mask in black and pump a few times into the bowl. Then I add Grassette of Sweden's conditioner and I mix it all up. I experiment like this until I get the right shade that I want. The more black I add, the darker gray it'll get. I lay my extensions flat on the ground and brush the dye on. When I'm done with one side, I flip it over and add more dye. I have 8 pieces of weft from this set, but I split them up so I add a mix of dark gray onto 4 pieces, and then I add more conditioner to my mix of dye and use the other 4 extensions with that one. I do this because I want to create highlights to my look. On my left pile you'll see the dark gray and on my right pile you'll see the light gray. I leave the dye in for approximately 30 minutes, then I wash it all out and wait for my extensions to dry. So that was the dyeing process, now moving on to my hair. I only clip on about 3 to 4 pieces into my hair when I make my braids because I don't need more. I usually use 1 weft of 3 clips, 1 weft with 4 clips, and then 2 wefts with 1 clip into my hair when I braid it. For this double side braid, I split my hair in the middle into 2 sections. Using my first section, I start braiding a French braid on the side of my head. I take 3 strands of hair and start braiding like a normal braid. Then I take small sections and add into the strand that is going over the middle strand, and I braid downwards, adding hair as I go until there is nothing left, and I keep braiding until I reach the end. Moving on to the other section, I will move that section over to my other shoulder and just do a normal braid. But before I do that, I'm just going to leave a small section of hair that I'm going to need in the very end. braids are done, I remove the hair ties and tie the two braids together into one braid. I tug and pull in my braids to make them thicker. Then I take that last strand and I'm going to sew my braids together by pulling the strand through my braid. That's my take on the double side braid. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please subscribe and comment if you did, and also feel free to tag me on Instagram and show me your take on this braid. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. It was really fun for me to make, and this video is not over just yet. I am having a giveaway together with VP Fashion, and it will end in 5 days from the day I posted this video. So there are 3 prizes, and the first prize is a 18-inch white blonde extension, and one winner will win this prize. And the second prize is 30% off on vpfashion.com, and 2 winners will win this prize. And the third prize is $30 off your order, and 3 people will win this prize. So there are 6 winners, 6 people that will win in this giveaway, and it is due in 5 days. So, on to the rules. So, rule number 1 is you have to subscribe to VP Fashion on YouTube, and you can see it here. You can also click on the link down below in the description box. And rule number 2 and 3, you also have to be a subscriber to my YouTube and follow me on Instagram, and if you already do that, then that's great. So if I wasn't clear enough, you can check out all the details down below and the rules and everything, and then you're set to go. So good luck on the giveaway if you're in, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!